Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Bully. Today I am going to show you guys how to add a multi-currency feature to your WooCommerce store to provide a better user experience to your customers in many countries. Do you know why it is important to add a multi-currency feature to your online store? It is because this feature will display the pricing in the local currency. It will make your customers happy because they can buy your products in their local currency. Before we get started, first off, I want to welcome back my subscribers. I always appreciate you all. And for those who are brand new to the channel, my name is Bully. I create tutorials and talk about e-commerce web designs using WordPress and WooCommerce. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet and turn on that bell notification so you won't miss any future uploads about web designs using WordPress from me. If you find this video helpful somehow, please give it a thumbs up. I would appreciate your support a lot. Thank you. There are also other best ways to help support my channel that I encourage you guys to check out my website about my merch and my web consulting services. I have a 20% coupon off for you guys to use for free shipping. If you guys don't want to support my channel that way, you can also join my Patreon for exclusive offers, or you guys could donate to my channel directly using PayPal. Thank you so much for your support. I always appreciate it. By the way, I have a private group to discuss e-commerce web designs on Discord. Join my private community if you're interested. It's always free to join. I add all the links in the description box below for you guys to check out. With that being said, let's get started. Let's go to my computer and log into my demo store. Go to plugins, add new, and search for currency switcher in the search box. We are going to install WooCommerce currency switcher by pluginus.net, Woo multi-currency, and Woo multi-pay by realmag777. Click to install and activate it. After you are done activating it, we are going to go back to the plugins page to enable the auto updates feature for the plugin. Let's scroll down a little bit. The plugin is right here. Enable that feature and then click on the settings to go to its settings. This is the main dashboard of the plugin. This is the free version of the plugin. It comes with two currencies. They set up the US dollar and the European euro as a default setting, so we are going to stick with it. For those question mark images on the right, they are for flags. I don't have an image of the American or the European flag for this tutorial, but if you guys want to add your flag images, you can download them on the internet for free and then just click right there to upload them. And we will leave everything pretty much the same for this tab. And there are many options for many styles how you're gonna add the currency switcher on your front page, but we are going to stick with the regular drop down. Once we are good with the first tab, we will switch to the next tab. The next tab is called Options, which the welcome currency, our default currency will be the US American dollar. And the currency aggregator will be the Yahoo Finance. We will leave the rest of the settings pretty much the same, except rate auto update. We will change that to hourly and scroll down a little bit more to the bottom of the page. We will leave the settings, the rest of the settings the same. Scroll down a little bit more to click on the save changes button. Next, we are going to take a look at the advanced tab. Mostly we don't have to worry about the settings in this tab at all. Just leave them the same. Leave the rest of the settings the same. They are working well already. Then we are going to go to the next tab, which is slide switcher. We are going to turn on the slider. That's the example of the image. That's we are going to set it up like that, but we're gonna remain the classic blocks and leave the rest of the top margin the same with the same pixels. But I am going to change the main color and the other color. Let's go to the front page to pick out some of the colors from my color palette here. I will try to get the hex code of the orange button. I am using the color picker. It is a Google Chrome extension. I am going to paste my hex code in here. For the main color, it will be orange. And the next one, the next color, I will shoot probably the blue color right here. Let's see how it goes. Well, let's see how it's gonna look like. You guys have to play around with your color palettes. Let's see which one will look the best for the color switcher that you will add into your online store. Once you are done with the colors, just scroll down to the bottom of the page to click the Save Changes button. For the rest of the tabs, GOIP and help, we don't need to worry about them, just leave them alone. Let's go to the front end and close out the color picker extension and refresh the page. Here it is. This is our currency switcher. Let's switch to the product page to see the price of the product. It looks like the color on my tabs, the blue, doesn't look good. And for the dollar currency, the position of the dollar symbol is at the end on the right side. So we are going to go back to the back end, to the dashboard, to change things up a little bit. Let's go back to the back end. We are going to select left for the dollar sign, click the Save Changes button at the bottom of the page, and let's check on the size switcher tab. I will change the hover color to black So the blue won't blend into the main top bar of the page. And then click Save Changes. And then let's go back to the front end and to refresh the page to see the changes. Okay, there we go. The currency tabs look so much better with the black and orange. And I need to check on to make sure that all the currency symbols will stay on the left with a space. That's what I just changed. So let's go back to the front page again to see all the changes. Let's toggle back to Euro. Scroll down a little bit here. Let's see pricing. Okay, there you go. That's all for today's tutorial. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think about adding a multi-currency feature to your online store. I would love to hear from you guys a lot. Anyway, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet and turn on that bell notification so you won't miss any future uploads about web designs from me. If you guys find this video helpful somehow, please give it a thumbs up to help support my channel. I would appreciate your support a lot. Thank you. Again, thank you for being here to watch my video. I appreciate your support a lot. I wish you guys have a wonderful day wherever you are. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye now.